me again. If any of you noticed, I was holding a little puppet when I was speaking earlier. I forgot to mention, if you get squirrely at all, I actually brought some of my personal puppet collection from when I was a kid. They're in the back. There's some books and there's some paper and coloring. So of any age, if you feel like doing that, you can head to the back there. I'll speak very briefly about this Dvořák trio. So this was a new piece for all of us, and we've become sort of obsessed with it. It's just a fabulous piece, but it's also a watershed piece for Dvořák. He was almost going to become a victim of his own success. He became fabulously famous and somewhat wealthy from his publication of the Slavonic dances. Now, this was the 19th century. There's no Netflix or TikTok or anything like that. And so a lot of people played music in the parlor after meals. And so the Slavonic dances became these huge hits, so much so that he wrote another set and he was asked to orchestrate it. But then he started to be known as, oh, you're the guy that writes the Slavic Czech music, right? Well, yes, that would continue his whole life, but he was an incredibly profound personal composer. And this came on the heel, this trio came on the heels of the death of his mother. And you can sort of hear an elegiac quality to it right from the beginning. The first movement is truly epic. It could be a symphony in itself. There's a lot going on. Andrei is basically we're the strings, but Andrei is like the brass, the winds, and the percussion, and it's a truly huge movement with lots of colors, textures. Now the second movement is it is a Czech dance. It's a furiant, which is a form that he used a lot. Now, a furiant straddles the line between being in three, one, two, three, one, two, three, and in two, one, two, one, two, one, two. So you're gonna hear that. And then there's this shimmering, almost like you're looking through water at something, a trio to give us a little break from the dance, and then a return. The third movement is one of the most personal and touching movements he ever wrote. Possibly an elegy for his mother. I'll just let that speak for itself. It's just feel lucky to be able to play it. The last movement is not the kind of barn burner piece that you might expect from a piece of this length. He's actually playing a lot of games of hide the downbeat and what meter are we in? Are we in two? Are we in three? So you can try tapping your feet to the last movement and see what happens. You'll be in a nice, comfortable groove and then suddenly it changes. This is a lengthy piece. It's about 40 minutes. So the puppets are at the back, the coloring and some books, but if you feel obliged to do so. But thank you again so much for coming. nice problem to have.